Hi there. So today I'm going to show you how to make this long cathedral veil with the lace trim. Now there's a couple things that make this different. First of all, it's two layers, two tiers instead of the one that you may have seen with other tutorials. But what's most unique about this veil is that after you're done with the ceremony and all the pictures, you can actually remove the cathedral part. And then you don't have to lug it around all evening or have some people step on it and get it all dirty. And then all evening throughout the reception, you can just wear this short veil. Now before we get started, go ahead, if you're not already there, go to myonlineweddinghelp.com/cathedral. And there you'll find the entire video tutorial as well as written instructions with photos and everything. So let's get started. Here are the materials and supplies you'll need to make your cathedral veil with lace trim. Now, I know this is a long list and it's hard to read in a video, so you can see this actually online at myonlineweddinghelp.com/cathedral, where you'll find full instructions as well as the supply list. Okay, for the material, I used 108-inch wide tulle fabric, which I folded into a 54-inch width for cutting. If you would like a less full veil, you can get narrower material. Then invisible or white thread. In the make the gather step, I show you both so you can make a decision which you like. Lace trim the length of the tulle edge you want to cover. If you want to cover the whole thing, then you'll need enough lace to go around the perimeter. If you do only part of it like I did, you'll need less. I have a veil length trim calculator online at, if you go to myonlineweddinghelp.com/trim length and put in the length of your veil, the width of your veil, and then what percent you want to cover the edge, then it'll tell you how many yards of lace you need. Next, sew on soft and flexible Velcro. Now this is not the regular Velcro that you get. This is a softer, it has a softer and more flexible feel, and you'll be able to get your needle through that easier than the regular. I'm using here, this is a no sewing machine tutorial, so it's just thread and a needle, which more of us have than sewing machines and how to use them through these difficult fabrics. Next, gridded graph fabric for the veil pattern, and I have a link to that over on the blog post so you can see what I used. Then a bridal comb. In the tutorial, I used the wide 4 1/4 inch. You could also use a regular size. And then as far as supplies, you'll need scissors, a tape measure, and pins or weights to hold the pattern to the veil while you're cutting it. And then also pins or clips to hold the lace trim to the veil while you're sewing it on. So let's get started with the first step. So there's 5 steps to making this cathedral veil. It's kind of pre-step one, I guess. You'll want to figure out how long you want the two tiers to be. This one is 10 feet for the cathedral length and 25 inches for the elbow length. But depending on what shoes you're wearing, the height, your body type, you'll probably want to have different lengths. So go ahead and figure that out first and get the tool. And then step one, when you get to creating the veil, is to make a pattern or figure out just what curve you want on the ends. And then step two is going to be using that pattern or what you figured out, go ahead and cut the two ends of your material. Step three is going to be to create the gathers. Now, you can actually put the lace on first before you do the gathers, but I had 10 feet of material here, and I just didn't want to, ruin the lace or snag it or anything like that. So in step three, I put these gathers in preparation for step four. So we've got 2 pieces of material, and one piece of that is going to be attached to the comb, and the long piece of that is going to be with Velcro. And then finally, in step five, we're going to add the lace. Now, If you're not already on the website, go ahead and go to myonlineweddinghelp.com/cathedral. And there you'll find the entire tutorial, both written and in video, and we can get started. To make a veil pattern, you will need some gridded pattern fabric, the lace that you are going to put around the edge of your veil or some other way to get yourself a smooth curve, a pencil, scissors, pins to pin down the lace, and then a tape measure or some other way to measure the length and depth of your curve. So let's get started. So I've now taken the veil and took my 108 inch wide and folded it over. So now I've got 54 inch wide, and I'm going to measure from one end of the lace to the other, and then at the direct center, how far my arc goes. That was shadow talking. Okay, so I've got, I started zero down there. So my curve is going to be a total of 66 inches, of which 33 is half of that. And it's going to arc out by 15 inches. Okay, now we're going to cut the pattern for the cathedral veil. Now this, what I've done is I've taken my 66 inches and cut out 66 inches of this gridded pattern paper. It's kind of like a, not paper, it's like a material. And I like the grids because I can't eyeball anything and get it right. So I'll put a link on the blog post, which is going to be at myonlineweddinghelp.com/cathedral veil. To what this is called and where to get it, because I can't think of it right now. Okay, so anyway, I did 66 inches. I decided I wanted 16 inches depth because it was just a little flat after I did the last step. So I cut 16 by 66, folded in half, and then we're going to make a pattern that's going to come out the full length of that oval that we, or that arc that we measured last time. So I took my lace, just kind of laid it out, pinned it, and then took a pencil, and I chose one section of the pattern on the lace that I wanted to mark each time. So now I've kind of steamed the pattern, which was all crumpled up, and the tulle, so that it would lay flat while I pinned it. And I put pins just here and there just to stabilize it. Shadow tried to work as a weight, but it just didn't work. Really? You gonna help? Yeah? Okay. I don't have to use pins now? Okay. Now it's time to cut. We'll unfold this, and we have a full 108 inch curve. So now I'm at the other end of the tulle, and I've already cut enough for my short tier, which is 25 inches. I've also laid out the pattern onto that shorter piece of tulle. Tulle's folded over. Notice I don't have the pattern all the way to the fold. That's because I want to make sure that middle section there is straight, so that I don't get like a heart pattern or something, because when that comes unfolded, I want that whole length to curve in, go straight, and then curve up the other way. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and cut the curve on my short tier, and then I'll be back.
I went ahead and finished cutting the curve on the 25 inch tier of the veil, and took off the pins and the pattern. And we've got 54 inches across. There's the folded side. And if we unfold it, we have an arc of 108 inches.
Next, we'll create gathers and attach the comb. Now, remember, this is a two-tier veil with a detachable long tier. So how this is going to work is here's the comb that goes against the head, into the hair like this. The top short layer, which will stay, is on the comb. This should wear to the reception. And then you take the cathedral long layer off. So this is the long layer, and it will peel off, and you leave just the shorter layer to walk around in and dance and all that stuff. So let's get started. So now I'm going to put the gathers in, and we're going to need to do this twice because remember we're going to have a detachable cathedral length. So I have the tool here for the 25 inch second tier, and I have it oriented so that the straight line is what I'm going to gather. I've got we're going to leave the arc alone that we cut out. And we have 108 inches of tulle to gather. So this takes a minute. I'll skip most of it. But what we basically want to do is we'll end up with the width of our comb, because that's what we're going to sew it onto. And all you do is just start pushing the needle back and forth through the tulle. I'm about an eighth of an inch from the edge. And then every once in a while, I'll pull it through. So now we're going to tie this off and find the beginning of your thread. We're going to tie it off at the width of the comb. So right there. Go ahead and get that end of the tool that gathers up to the edge. And then make a couple little loops. Okay, so now we have the gathers for the short tier, the width of the comb. And this is going to end up going on the back of the comb. Next, I'll go ahead and put the gathers in the cathedral length of the tier of the veil. I won't show you because it's going to look identical. You just want to make sure that you're putting it on the straight edge and not what you not where you're going to put the lace. So I will be back, and then we'll get to attaching the tiers to the comb. Okay, so now I have my gathers put in both parts of the veil. I went ahead and used that invisible thread on the long tier just so you could kind of see the difference. These are not going to be seen in general, but if you care, the invisible thread just is invisible. It's a little harder to work with, but if you want it to look neater, that's an option. And I'll put a link to that in the full tutorial at myonlineweddinghelp.com/cathedral, and then you can make your own choice on what to do. Okay, so we have these, and what we're going to do, to remind you, I have a lot of tulle going on here, is we're going to attach a comb. I'm going to attach a bigger comb than I did on this one, and one half The Velcro is going to go on the comb. The short tier is going to be sewn onto the comb. Now remember, the short tier, because the purpose of this, for this veil, which is a cathedral length two-tier veil with an elbow length of 25-inch top tier, is that after the picture, the ceremony and the pictures and everything, you can take that long tier off and then go to the reception with only the shorter veil. What we're going to need is a piece of soft sew-on Velcro that's the length of your comb. Now, it's important. This is not the regular stiff Velcro, because you're going to need to get a needle through there. So this is almost, the one side's almost like felt, and the loopy side is not as stiff as regular. And then your comb, I'm using for the tutorial, I'm doing a 4-inch comb. And then piece of thread knotted, I'm going to use white so you can actually see. You can use invisible if you'd like. Okay, so now we're going to sew the comb onto the short tier of your veil. Now, if you are a good sewer, which I am not, you can sew the veil and the piece of Velcro on at the same time. I tried it, it did not work. So we're going to do it one at a time. I've got the loopy part of the soft sew-on Velcro that's going to go in the front of the comb. See, the curved part is what's going to go against your head. The front's going to have the Velcro. The back is going to have the short piece of the veil. And this takes a sharp needle that is, the Velcro is softer than normal Velcro, but it still takes a sharp needle. And be careful. If you're a good sewer, like I said, you'll do this much better. If you are not a sewer, like I am not a sewer, it's possible, because I'm going to show you right here how a non-sewer can do this, which is pretty much how a sewer can, except that it's going to be less visually appealing. So I came in from the back, and then I'm going to go over and just go through each tooth. Okay, now I have the Velcro sewed onto the front of the comb, and I promise yours can look much nicer, but one of the points is that to show you what a non-sewer work would look like. So if you can sew, I promise you it's going to look better and the stitches will be nicer. So next, what we're going to do is we're going to sew the short tier of the veil onto the back of the comb. Now, how this is going to work, it's going on the back, and it will be against your head. And then when you're wearing this is the top tier, so it's going to be over the comb. And I ended up with my gathers a little longer than my comb here, you can see. So what I'm going to do, and this is also might just be a good idea anyway, is I'm going to tack each end, and then I'm going to sew from side to side just to make sure I get it evenly through there and don't end up with something on the end that I didn't want. And I'm going to use the thread in the gather as a guideline to sew this on. So I'm sewing it to the back of the comb with the raw edges down. Are the two ends tacked? And then I'm going to go ahead and sew across and end up with something like this. And I will be back. As I'm sewing this comb, these last few stitches, I'll show you where I'm catching it. So I'm going in and out of each tooth at the base, the very top of the tooth, And on the back side, I'm being sure to catch, I'm not sure how much you'll be able to see, but I'm catching that thread that makes the gather. So I'm making sure that's on the bottom side so that we don't miss any. And then just going back and forth at the top of each tooth. We have the comb attached to the short tier of the veil. Next, we're going to put the other piece of the Velcro onto the cathedral length, and I'll show you how that goes. So now I'm going to sew the soft side of the Velcro onto the cathedral length of your veil. And how this is going to work is that this is the velvety part, goes onto the Velcro, and this is going to be attached to the long part of the veil. And I'm going to sew it so that it's actually tucked underneath like that. And you'll see the tool will stick to the, it will stick, but it doesn't stick as well if you don't use the other side of the Velcro. So what I'm going to do is just take this and I'm going to tack or sew the veil along the bottom edge, but underneath. So this part's the velvety, this part is the back. And I will do that and then show you in a second. So I'll finish this up. And what I'm doing, soft velvety side of that half of Velcro is on the bottom. This is the back, and I'm just sewing the veil to the velvety side. Now we're ready to put on the trim. So all I did here is just so you can see what it's going to look like. I clothespinned. I'll probably put a couple another clips or something on there just as a guide when I go back into the other room and start sewing it on. So let's do that. Now I'm going to use that invisible thread to start sewing my veil, my lace trim onto the veil. So what I have here is, this is from the back. So on top I have the veil, and then underneath I have the embroidered trim, the lace trim with the front surface down. And we're going to sew this on about halfway through. So half of the pattern is below the veil, the edge of the veil, and half of the pattern is up. And we're going to catch the pieces that are up here. So the top pieces, and I'm going to make big stitches. So I'll just start out. First I'll attach. I'll make a little loop at first. Probably this just looks like I'm pantomiming, but I swear I've got thread. So I've sewn the first one here. And you can see it's attached. It's not going to come off. And I'm going to go ahead and do all the way around, or the third way around that I have the lace on this, and then I'll take pictures and show you the finished piece.